Greetings, Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020 friends, and welcome to Patriot 6. This tutorial is part of a series of single subject videos designed for quick reference to supplement my long form tutorials. If you're new to using SDK or need a refresher on the tools, I recommend a tutorial on getting started and learning the tools. This tutorial will give you all the basics from obtaining SDK and setting up scenery folders to operating the developer camera and building polygons. You can find a link to this tutorial in the description below. Please click on the Show More button and the tutorial will be the first YouTube link you see. And now on to the quick reference guide. Welcome back to Patriot 6. I'm going to pick up where I left off in 2 Echo Quick Reference Guide, Building a Fictional Airport. The Plan. So here's the plan for this video. I'm going to add water to the dried pond. I'm going to add a static Cessna livery and have it orientated properly on the ground. I'm going to add a fence using vector placement. I'm going to add cattle and hay. And this will be the last video on this part of Papa 6 Kilo Yankee. So let's get started.
Adding water to the dry pond.
And here we have a pond where the water's not showing up. Let's draw a polygon around this pond. Okay, the polygon is built. We want to go back to the properties, to water, and let's select pond. And we have water in the pond now.
Build a fence using vector placement.
And let's build a fence. I don't need the materials. So the easiest way to do this, and I'm certainly not an expert at it. In fact, this is going to be my first time. I did experiment around a bit before starting this tutorial. So I actually have some parameters in mind. On the objects window, let's go to vector placement. And we're looking for NZRO farm fence. And here we go right here. Now I'm going to tick add. And I'm going to keep the left control key down. And I'm going to draw the line for the fence. With the control key held down and with each left mouse tick, I set a node. Double click to end the placement. Now you barely see them now, but here's what I've learned. We're going up to the properties, and where it says spacing between models, I'm going to take that to 6. Now I'm going to do this avoid discontinuity and adjust the scaling path will automatically be there. And we should have a pretty decent fence here now. So let me say something about the fence. When I added this fence with a vector placement, I used a spacing of 6 meters between the models. Now that will depend upon the model, so you may have to adjust the vector placement to work best for you. But that's what worked on this particular model for me. And it doesn't appear the fence is too close to the runway. Good. Now we have this area fenced off. Let's save the scenery.
Add cattle and hay.
And let's find some cows to put out here. So let's go back up to the objects. And let's go back down to scenery. Tick all and type in COW. So this is Dave's 3D animals, and I will link it below. You can find this on flightsim.to. We only have 3 types here, so what I'm going to do is select each type, do some one tick placing real quick, and then we can reorientate them. Let's do some force. And do some fives. Now they're all facing the same direction, so we want to tick on them. And on the gizmo, go to rotate and just give ourselves a few options. I'm going to save the scenery, and I'm going to look for hay. We have different types of hay bales, so we just have to find one we want. So let's drop a few of these out here. So I could just duplicate, make another, and move it. And let's save the scenery again.
Add a static Cessna 152.
On the objects window, let's change from scenery to sim objects. And let's look for our 152. Okay, now let's use the gizmo to move this. I'm going to rotate this around in a direction facing this way. Now, sometimes these sim objects are buried in the ground, so I'll show you what I do. So up here on the properties, I have the Cessna 152 ticked. I'm going to remove snap to ground. And with the gizmo on translate, I'm going to bring it up to the top of the ground. That looks good. So now, again, let's save the scenery.
Build the package and move it to the community folder to test the project at this stage.
And I'm going to remove the properties. I no longer need that. Right now, we're done with this project. We're done with the farm side of it. And I'm going to build the package. But I'm going to build it at this stage, and I'm going to move it to the community folder, and we're going to take a look at it. So you want to tick off the scenery BGL and go to the package. And everything should show up in the inspector. And down here, we're going to build the package. And the package is completed, and I have not contributed any errors. So I can X out the console, X out the tools. Everything's saved and built. So let's bring up the community folder. And let's bring up the working scenery folder. And let's find P6KY here. And let's open the packages. Want to copy this package and paste into the community folder. And the package down here is in the community folder. And let's restart the sim, come back here and see what we have. Okay, the simulator has been restarted with the package in the community folder. So let's go up to our departure and type in Papa 6 Kilo Yankee. And here's the West Paducah Airfield. And let's start here at 03 left, the grass runway. Okay, here we are. So let's go up to the options, pause the sim, hit ready to fly, and let's take a look with the developer camera and see what we have here. We see the grass turnaround I made. I can see the street lights that I put in for the buildings. We can see the cattle and the hay. You see the path I made from the dirt runway. And I wanted to gradually thin the path out. And I made 3 different polygons and made each one gradually more opaque. We see our livery here. And see if it's sitting on the ground like it should be. And it is. Let's take a look at our fence. The fence row looks really good. I'm pleased with the fence and the outcome of that. Pleased with the textures and how I blended those all together, although it is a personal taste. And we see waters in the pond. So let's turn the lights down and see how things look in the dark. And we see the light reflecting off the pond. That was the look I was hoping to get. We see the lights I placed at the houses. More lights. And the parking lot that I lit up with street lamps. Not bad.
Wrap up.
And that will conclude the work that I'll be doing on the farm section of the airfield. I will continue this series on the asphalt side, where I plan to build a complete airport. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you learned something from it. And I hope you continue to watch. If you're not a subscriber of Patriot 6, please reach down there and tick the subscribe button. I try to put out helpful content. And I try to keep my content up to date. So if the processes change, then I will bring on a new video. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. I will see the question and I will answer your question to the best of my ability. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Please go down in the description below. Tick on the show more and you'll see all kinds of links. I will have a link to Dave's animals down there that I got from flightsim.to. There is a link to the Patriot 6 scenery group. There's links to relevant content that would help you do this work. particularly if you're new, along with the chapters of this video should you need to come back and review part of this video. And again, thank you for watching. If you're a subscriber, thank you for supporting Patriot 6, and I will see you soon. Be safe and take care.